We'll now use the VR view panel to position graphics. In the Gallery 2 scene, add a new layer above the hotspots layer and rename it More Info. Open the 09end.fla library, if it's not already open, and drag the More Info movie clip symbol from the library panel onto the stage. The More Info symbol is added to the 09_WorkingCopyFLA library panel. The symbol is a simple graphic of a More Info signpost and transparent shadow to make it appear as if it is suspended in air. Open the VR view panel if it's not already opened. Click the Launch VR View or Refresh VR View. The panel refreshes the display to reflect the addition of the More Info instance on the stage. Drag the More Info instance around the VR view panel. Notice how it warps slightly around the edges of the panel to keep the object consistent with the spherical projection. Drag the movie instance close to the standing statue and release it. The movie clip instance on the stage moves to the corresponding position. You can add another More Info movie clip symbol to the stage. And then in the VR view, click Refresh. Drag the second More Info instance in the VR view panel close to the painting opposite the standing statue. Notice the painting is split by the image. Part of the painting is on the left and part is on the right. When Animate wraps this texture around, the edges are stitched together. The VR view panel helps you position objects when you need to be working close to the seam or at the outer edges, where distortion is more pronounced. You'll move the virtual camera to have the user automatically look at a more interesting part of the room when they first enter the Gallery 3 scene. In the Scene panel, switch to Gallery 3. Select the first frame of the Actions layer and open the Actions panel. In the Actions panel, place your cursor on a new line at the end of the code. Click the Add Using Wizard button to open the wizard. In step 1, select Set Camera Position. Code is written at the top preview panel. The values of the camera position in X, Y, and Z can be changed in the code. The X value is currently highlighted. For the X value, enter 120. For the Y value, negative 10. And for the Z value, enter 30. Click Next. The X value refers to the camera view from left to right. The Y value refers to the view up and down, and the Z value refers to the angle of view. These values make the camera turn to the left, turn slightly up with a wider view. In step 2, select With This Frame as the triggering action. With This Frame means the action will be executed when the playhead hits the frame on the timeline. Click Finish and Add. Additional code is added to the current script in the Actions panel. Test your project. In the browser window, click the right doorway to move to the Gallery 3 scene. The code you wrote sets the camera position so the initial view now shows more of the paintings and none of the doorway. Your VR project is complete, and now it's time to publish. Choose File, Publish Settings to open the Publish Settings dialog box. If you want to disable automatic looping of the timeline, deselect Loop Timeline. For this project, just keep it selected. If you want to rely on JavaScript libraries that are already on the internet, keep the Use JavaScript Hosted Libraries option selected. This option allows you to publish leaner files because you don't have to include more JavaScript code. Click Publish. Animate exports the necessary JavaScript code and graphics assets from your library panel. If you check the 09 Start folder, you'll see that Animate organizes the code and assets in folders. All those files are necessary along with the 09_working_copy_html document to play your VR project in a browser.